Jason, Drake Maye is ridiculous. I mean, I don't know how else to put it. The kid, it looks like a shark bit him. He's bleeding terribly out of his hand. He doesn't even miss a beat. He looked like a couple throws where he was right. I'm running. Nope, there's somebody open. I mean, just overall, what'd you see Saturday night?
Well, we saw why, in my view, Drake Maye will be not just a top five pick, but probably the number one pick in the draft when he comes out.
No question.
And I mean, what you see when you have that kind of player is he gets hit, he gets, you get pressure on him or whatever, and those kind of guys. Don't and you saw this from Narduzzi talked about this in the pregame, right? And before the game, it was a interview, what, a couple days before the game, where he talked about the difference between the quarterback last year, obviously Sam Howell, and Drake Maye. And everything he said was accurate. He talked about that. I'm going to read the quote. When I watched last year, as good as their quarterback was, if he didn't feel good, he would just tuck it and run or get hit and sacked. Now, folks on Inside Carolina will remember that that was something that I kept saying, and folks kept getting mad. But it was the truth. Great deep ball thrower, a guy that when things were good, when he felt good about what was going on, could really put the ball in there, but had some flaws in terms of processing speed to get the ball out, and just managing things when read one wasn't there. Here's what Narduzzi then said. This guy is not like that. He's elusive. He's really smooth in the pocket. There's time when he's just shuffling to the left away from it and he feels the pressure well. He's as good a quarterback. We were talking as a defensive staff. We were discussing like, who is this guy like? He's like a Trevor Lawrence, is like what I think he is. He can throw every ball. He's not afraid to put it out there. He is talented. Now, I think the Trevor comparison is a little different because I think Trevor had a stronger arm or has a stronger arm in terms of just being able to just from any body position make, laser type throws to any point on the field. And that's not to take away from Drake Maye has a terrific arm. But here's the thing. I think Drake Maye right now, in as far as I would grade what I value in a quarterback, might be a better prospect than Trevor Lawrence was at this stage of their careers.
Uh-oh, them high praise now.
And the reason is, Trevor, first of all, Trevor played on an offense that, and also had the support of a defense that was just, I mean, it was so silly what he had around him. Now, look, with Josh Downs, with the way that Antoine Green is playing, it's not like Drake Maye is playing with a bunch of stiffs. But to me, the thing that I value as much as anything else when grading a quarterback is the ability to slide in the pocket, to get the ball out quickly against pressure, to be able to handle some of those things. That's where Drake Maye is as good as anybody. And when you have those guys that okay, we're going to blitz him, we're going to pressure him, we're going to get in their face. You have that kind of guy who's like, oh, good, game on. I love it when teams do this because now I can get it out quickly and I've got my one-on-ones. Then those guys are terrifying to play against for a defensive coordinator. And that's what he is.
As long as we're in the Drake portion of the program, here's the thing that this just gives you a great look at who Drake Maye is. Slovis hit three Pittsburgh receivers. Three Pittsburgh receivers caught a pass last night. Drake hit 10 different guys, 10 different guys. What does that tell you? Drake sees the entire field. And if you get open, he's going to get you the ball. Now, granted, we will see some times where some people are open and Drake doesn't get them the ball and for whatever reason, but his ability to scan the entire field and have the arm to get it to where he wants to go accurately is just unparalleled. And what's a little bit of a shame, in his press conference after the game, Mac Brown almost sounded apologetic towards Sam Howell and the previous offense, because he was comparing how they were unable to finish at Pittsburgh the last two times they played up there, having the ball on the 2-yard line with minute 16 to go. I'll never forget that as long as I live. He keeps always bringing up a minute 16 to go, first and goal at the 2, and couldn't close the deal. Drake Maye would have got that ball in the end zone. I have complete confidence one way or the other. He'd have won the game for North Carolina. And, you know, as much as we love Sam Howell and as much as we love those teams, there's just a significant gap between what Sam Howell's able to accomplish on the football field and what Drake Maye can do. And I think a lot of that stems from, yes, he has all the physical abilities in the world, and as Jason talks about and I talk about at times, but his vision, I think, and having the accuracy to get the ball where he wants to go, those are the things that separate him, in my opinion.